the impact of Buffalo on Buffalo, of, you know, bringing these games here. But as you might imagine, New York State and Washington, D.C. are going to get on the benefit as well, thanks to the players' salaries. So this is really interesting from our partners at Buffalo Business First, because the Jays are playing here in New York. The players have to pay state and federal taxes on their salaries. So just out of a payroll of almost $650,000 per day, that means $310,000 goes to the feds and $70,000 headed to Albany. No chump chains.
No, not at all. And the visiting teams also pay taxes on the money they make while playing here. So if the Jays end up sticking around for the rest of the season, that adds up to more than almost $7 million for the state, $27 million for the U.S. And that's all money that would have otherwise gone to Canada. It's also a little less than the team would have paid in taxes on the other side of the border. So they're saving a little bit here as well.
Yeah, it also doesn't include any potential playoff games here. Wouldn't that be nice? Or other financial impacts like taxes on hotel stays for the Jays and the visiting team. So certainly some money to be made here for our different levels of government. Right now, we want to get some perspective on all of the excitement surrounding all of this. And there's really nobody better to talk about that than former Bison's general manager, Mike Bellani. If you haven't read The Seasons of Buffalo Baseball, almost 400 pages, Mike. And I know that there are stories in your head that you ran out of pages to even put in this book. So it's great to have you here.
Well, thank you very much. Yeah, there's a story going on right here that could be in the book. But we have last year there, but they played in front of cutouts. Tonight they're playing in front of real fans for the first time at a major league game since 1916.
I mean, that's unbelievable when you think of that, how long that has been. But what are people in for tonight?
Well, I think the biggest thing is you're going to see that the top players in the world playing baseball here. I'm most looking forward to, in the book, it talks about the great home run hitters of Buffalo. Luke Easter, Jeff Manto, Roy Hobbs, and I'm hoping added to that list will be Vlad Guerrero Jr., who could launch it over the scoreboard onto Oak Street, so they'll be talking about him for years to come.
Yeah, he is really fun to watch, and to see it in person is a whole different kind of experience. I know that you're among the lucky fans who has scored some tickets. You're going to be going to quite a few of these games. What are you really kind of looking forward to the most as the season progresses?
Well, my wife Debbie and I are so excited. We've been to other cities. We have our friend Sammy V with us, and we're just looking forward to seeing some great Major League plays. You know, you just see defensive plays. You see the pitching that is so precise. There's a big difference between AAA and Major League Baseball that is absolutely amazing that people are going to see. But more than that, they're going to see a Major League field.
Yeah.
This has been totally redone. The bullpen's out in the outfield, seeing the pitcher run in from the fence. It's big league.
Yeah.
And you and Steve were chatting, you know, earlier today. We had his report earlier in the show about whether or not Major League Baseball could really be in Buffalo. What's your take on that?
Kate, Major League Baseball is in Buffalo. And it's going to be here all year. And the Jays are going to win the World Series here in November.
But what about beyond that?
Well, you know, the economics of baseball were against us back when Bob and Mindy Rich fought tirelessly and spent a lot of money to bring Major League Baseball here in the form of trying to buy the Montreal Expos and then an expansion team. But unfortunately, Major League Baseball isn't like the NFL, where small markets can compete because of a salary cap and revenue sharing. Here they don't have that, so it makes it very tough for small markets.
And Mike, we just have about 30 seconds left, but how important is it? You've got a Jays hat on, right? Maybe, I know there are a lot of Yankees fans watching right now, so maybe in a few weeks they'll be cheering for the Yankees, but for Buffalo to really rally around this team.
Oh, I think my number one thing for the fans is get in here and cheer loudly and make the Jays feel this is their home. And many of the players here, Biggio and Vlad and others, have played here. If they can make them feel like they're at home, last year they propelled them into the playoffs for the first time in several years. Plus, we're going to get so much national publicity just out of this uniqueness of a Major League team playing in front of fans. And these are Buffalo fans.
Yeah.
Look at what they do for the Bills and Sabres. I mean, you know they're big.
It's always a treat to talk to you, Mike Bellani. Thanks again for coming on and chatting with
us
tonight.
Thanks, Michael, and continued best on what you're doing.
Thank you, Mike. We really appreciate it. Thank you, everybody, for being with us on this special edition of the Town Hall. But don't go away, because our live coverage continues with Channel 2 News at 6 after this break.